and I'll tape them together. Start all over again, who it's from.
Okay, this is a letter written by Brent Perry's from the Eagle Creek Barton Community Council. This was actually written yesterday on September the 11th of 2020. It says, all is much better today. However, yesterday, after all Clackamas fire pulled off every fire about 12:15 p.m., saying all fires were out of control. We all had to be out of harm's way. Once it was declared a disaster, the governor got federal money from FEMA. But with this, it also took the coordination efforts away from all fire departments in this area, including the forestry department. Our hand crews, with our fire equipment, one dozer has successfully contained the Eagle Creek Dowdy Road fire from Dowdy Road through Bonnie Lure Park to Folsom Road back to Highway 211, 224.
And if you look on my video, I'll post a link on here, you can see the fire exploding. And then I showed how the fires were being started on Barton Park and then up Baker's Ferry and then Springwater, about 20 minutes apart.
It says we had some help from Clackamas Fire and many locals. I have to say the fire department might know how to extinguish structure fires. However, they know little about brush fires. I coordinated our efforts with Battalion Chief Burke Slater. After he saw what we could accomplish with our crews, they began serving our needs towards controlling this side of the fire. We also had dozers and track hoes at Kinsey Road making fire trails around structures and properties. All of the heavy equipment was up Fall Creek Road and Tamala Mountain Road yesterday, making fantastic progress on containing those fires when Clackamas Fire said to get out. We were all dumbfounded. No wind. Some media hype about the fires meeting together to cause a catastrophic event. Yes, this could have happened, but first we needed wind. Never transpired. We all stood down, except for the locals, who never gave up. All the gallant efforts on this end is because the locals never gave up and ran for cover. Remarkable. Today, the feds took over, waiting for orders, still waiting. Some of our logging equipment is at Blue River, where the first big event happened. Now we are headed down to try and retrieve what's left.
How many structures were lost at Blue River?
I don't know.
And remember there at the end of Folsom, across the highway from Folsom Road, I watched a great big pile of logs go up in flames. I have that on video. That was set by a Molotov cocktail.
We stayed to try to keep helping locally, but it seems to be taking some time to get coordination to take place. So this gave us time to help ourselves. We own and run Pacific Forest Contractors, Incorporated, here in Eagle Creek. We have been in this industry of logging and road building for 34 years now. I have been educating this new generation of manpower that works for us on the proper ways to extinguish brush fires. Through my experiences in working on uncontrolled burns and reacting to extreme events throughout the state has given us on-the-job training that most of our fire departments cannot get. We feel we are a great asset to the community and to our industry partners.
Yes.
We will continue to be of service to whomever shall call for help.
And aren't they the one that delivered great big tanks full of water to...
Yes, and the dozer as well.
Oh, really? Yeah, to Sandages?
Mm-hmm. It says, thanks for checking in. Brent Perry's Eagle Creek Barton Community Council, P.O. Box 101, Eagle Creek, Oregon, 97022. And then it has the website here.
Wow.
Thank you.
And Sandage's home is still in danger. It's surrounded by smoldering trees. And they've been bringing water. And the fire truck did show up at their place. And how long was the fire truck there?
I wasn't there for that. I don't know.
But they left. They told. What did they tell Greg?
They just said they'd been recalled. The government recalled all all fire departments.
Yeah, and told them disengage.
Told them, control, you can't handle this. So everybody, all fire departments were recalled. That's all I know.
This is crazy. So what do you think? Yes, I know. So what do you think is going to happen?
I don't know. As far as the fires go, I think that that's wonderful that the fires are apparently stopped and from spreading, at least in this area.
There's no wind.
And there's been zero wind all for 2 days now. There's been no wind at all.
But right now there's a whole bunch of fires that have started in Oregon City.
Yeah, I mean, they don't, when it's this cold, it's only 60s. It's only 60 degrees right now. So it's not even 7 o'clock in the evening. It's 60, it never even got up to 65 degrees here today. So it's cold, zero wind, and the smoke is hanging on the ground. There's no way fires would just start.
No.
And there's no lightning in the area, there's no clouds at all, only smoke. So there's no way those fires started by themselves. Somebody had to do it.
And how about the fires that were started up on Wildcat?
I don't know.
Okay, the guy that was arrested for starting the bales of hay on fire outside of Estacade?
Yeah, somebody was arrested this morning for that.
Okay, and a lot of people are being armed and they're standing guard at the end of the street. So anyway, thank you for reading that, Larry.
Sure.
I'll leave a link of the copy of this here. And then the links to Sandage's home. Please keep them in your prayers. He just had kidney transplants a couple years ago and then a brain tumor. So he had brain surgery too. So his wife works two jobs and they are really good people. They raised a bunch of foster kids, and they can't lose their home. Anyway, I'd like to do a GoFundMe page to help put their house back together. So I'll leave you links. Thank you for reading that, Larry.